So my name is James. My in-game name is Liquid or Liquid2K. I was from Reality Rift Esports competing in Valorant, and now I'm currently competing in Counter-Strike with my startup Fear Esports. Growing up, right, my parents most of the time will be working, so I'll be home alone, like just by myself from like even like primary school days. So then since I really had like nothing much to do, then I started dabbling in like using the computer, finding like online games. Like, it started with like Minecraft, then after that it like slowly progressed, and eventually I found this game Counter-Strike Global Offensive, which my dad bought for me during Christmas. And from there I just got hooked. I kind of like enjoyed the competitive like experience, kind of like competing with other people. And only I think after 2 years of playing it kind of like casually, did I first get introduced to like esports in general. I went to an event at Bugis where it was just like 10 PCs and people were like on the stage playing and, you know, shouting each other, you know, just like competing in general. And that really kind of like sparked the interest for me, knowing that there's like a growing scene in Singapore. From there, I just like, my passion just grew more and more, and I just put in way more hours into the game, and slowly I just got to know the scene and started competing actively. I wasn't exactly doing poorly in school, but I wasn't doing great either. So, you know, parents being parents will always say like, stop spending so much time on the games. Like, they were like ban me from playing, and like, so I could focus on my studies and all that. Of course, there's a lot of these stigmas, and of course, when I told them about my dream of competing and becoming like a pro gamer, there'll be a lot of doubts, and like, they'll think like you're crazy and stuff. So that's the most straightforward one that I think a lot of Asian players face, because esports is not really recognized yet. But I'm glad to say that after Reality Rift, when contract and opportunities, and like to show them like there was actually like potential for money to be made and all that, that's when they really like changed their mind and changed their outlook on esports. It was interesting because, you know, we all had like different points of views on esports. So we came together and we thought, you know, right now companies in general are like struggling to kind of like engage the current generation. Because I think our generation, the humor or the things we're interested in is actually quite like different compared to like the previous generation. So esports being an up and coming like industry, you know, we decided that it might be a good opportunity to start a business about it. And through this, we can also help grow the esports ecosystem, because we plan to host events and at the same time, you know, create content and, you know, build around the marketing of esports, which will generally benefit esports players. We definitely would like to kind of try to help the esports industry kind of grow so that it can become more commercialized, to kind of change people's opinions on the industry, and to get further funding in so that like the esports industry as a whole can grow.